Yo, what's going on YouTube, as gamers and hobbyists, and welcome to another episode of On the Bench with Pete. This is the paint along or build along series where you get to paint your miniatures, put this video on in the background and just listen to me ramble whilst I paint, or in this case build. This episode I'm concentrating on Space Wolves, specifically the Space Wolves from the Stormclaw box set. So if you're unfamiliar with that one there. Now, as you may or may not know, I've already done the orcs from that set, so now it's the turn of the Space Wolves, and so let's crack on with that, shall we? Hello and welcome. This is the where I'm going to be working, using this little tiny cutting mat. I think I got it with a magazine, I can't remember now. It's a tiny one anyway. So I'm starting off with Crom Dragon Gaze. That's him. Excuse me. Excuse the noise. But there. Him there. It looks like to me in the picture on the back of the box he's on one of the bigger bases, which would make sense given that he's an HQ. So I'm going to start by cutting out his bits and bobs from this sprue. There's no other indication that that is who he is, just that I can tell by the sprue. Let's put my glasses down so I can see what I'm doing here. Right, so another week gone. The week's going fast. Didn't January go quick? Although technically it's the longer month for most people. It flew by, didn't it? Not quick enough for payday though, eh? Right, well, I think what I'll do with this is just cut all the bits out. Or shall I? I might leave the arms. Yeah. According to this, according to the instructions, this little rocky bit goes onto the base first. In such a manner or way, and that's fine. You know, I see the foot that goes on it, so it's got a little. See, to me, that looks like it's got a little knobbly bit on it. And it has. Right, sorry about this. What you will find is that I talk, although technically I am talking to myself, I talk to myself in more of a way rather than soliloquize what I'm saying, you know, so apologies for that. I do that a lot when I'm building and painting. I bet you'll have noticed it on other On the Bench episodes. Well, now, all being well, because I pre-record a lot of these videos, all being well, you'll have seen that my YouTube channel of the week this week was for a paid YouTube channel. But technically, it's a 14-day free trial, you don't have to pay for it, do you? Because you can check it out for free. So I like to share the love where I can. And when it's something I happen to think... excuse me. Sorry about that, my backpack flew off onto the floor. Yes, as I was saying, when it's something I think is really worthwhile and good quality, I mean, I like to bring it to your attention. And you know, I don't get anything out of it, so and I wonder why you get a thumbs down on things like you're mentioning YouTube channels. So, and you say, check out this channel because I think it's awesome. It's bizarre. Anyway, enough of that. I'm sure you know my feelings on down thumbing videos by now. So we won't harp on about it. Even though I think it's silly. You can see why Facebook doesn't have a dislike rather button. People will probably murder each other over it. Now I've got my little files here. These are jewellery files actually. I've got them from China. Some shop in China. I've got a couple of sets. And they're ideal for plastic. It's not too aggressive on the plastic when you rub them, but they're also equally viable for metal miniatures too, so that's good. Obviously they don't last forever, but in fact I'm thinking of getting myself a new set already, but well, I say already, it's been a couple of years I've been using these, so they do dull down. Right, I think that's about ready. Yeah. So what I'm gonna do is put some thick plastic glue on here. I like to try and follow these as much as I can, you know? Right, so that, to me, that is as it should be, right. Okay. I really enjoyed doing the orcs from this set, gotta say. Gruk Face Ripper, he was amazing. Loved doing him. These space wolves are a strange beast. There we go. Lovely detail on it. Still a bit of a dry fit here. Actually, I'm gonna just rub that down slightly. Then do a dry fit. Right, okay. Yeah, going back to the paint YouTube channel then. I mean, it's a YouTube channel. Sure, you pay for it, but you get a free trial option, don't have to pay for it then. You can see if you like it or not, and then if you don't like it, cancel your subscription to that channel. So I don't see anything wrong with that. In fact, I think that's pretty neat. There's not many paid YouTube channels out there in our niche. Most people rely just on Patreon, which is what I do. Some people have gone the route of a paid YouTube channel and then Patreon to support their free channel, which is fine. What I'm trying to do is the other way around. I'm trying to sort out my Patreon so that I can get enough financial support to then produce a good enough quality material for a paid channel. Yeah, like so many others, he says, oh yeah, he wants to do it for a living rather than work. Yeah, well, as it stands, I don't really have much choice in the matter, given that nobody seems to want to employ me because of my medical condition. So, try and do what I enjoy. For a time. As long as I can, anyway. Thing with paid channels is you've got to have at least 1,000 subscribers anyway, so which I don't have, so... Right, so that's going to go over there. This is looking more and more like he should be on a normal base. Chrom Dragon Gaze. Gotta look on the box. See, on the instructions, he's depicted as being on a small base. But in this box here, he's not. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, I think I'm going to put him on a... Put him on a base like that, so he's not hanging off the edge. Sorry about that. It's like, it's bizarre. Some of these set. I mean, it doesn't tell you what base you should use, but I'm gonna put him on that, given that he's an HQ anyway. And if it turns out that there's not enough bases. I'll put him on whoever's missing a base, I'll just get a spare base for them. That's how I'm going to do it. Ah, dear. So, this is reminiscent of the Bolt Action Maneuvers DVDs I used to make. I know I haven't done one of those for a very long time. The legs are on, as far as I'm concerned. Right, I'm going to look at the cloak section now. Nice little pattern on it. A bit of flash down there that he's sorting out. Goodness me, I'm actually cutting away from myself on this one. I always cut wherever it seems easiest to control where you're cutting. It's all very well not cutting to yourself, but sometimes the situation dictates otherwise. It would be a lot easier. You either cut towards yourself or mess up the model. I'm cutting towards myself, like now. Yeah.
this. Chrome Dragon Gaze. I know nothing about Space Wolves at the moment. I do have their codex. I shan't be looking at it until... well, until I've at least completed some of the army. So, yeah. Well, that's pretty cool. He's got a front bit to go on here as well. Loads of detail on that. That looks really, really, really good. He says really, 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 really. The only miniature from Games Workshop so far that I've ever had an issue with is the Age of Sigmar Korgoroth, because he's got like an earring that keeps breaking off every time I pick him up. So I've decided I'm going to just leave it off and cut the other one off to even it up, because I'm just fed up with it, to be honest. Right. It's dry fittings all very well, but sometimes the parts are very small. Right, okay. Right, gotcha. Ah, it's warming up in here a bit now. I didn't come out till later because, well, I've been not feeling so good. That's why YouTube channel of the week went up later, because I'd left my microphone out here. But it's nice and peaceful. That's one good thing. That's looking good. I'll dry fit that to that way. You can't. Oh, I see. I see how it works. I see. You think, oh, it's gonna be really, really easy, because it's only a, one figure sprue. Sometimes it's not, though, is it? Okay, so he's talking about arms on the instructions next. Arms, whatever next. Thankfully, I actually prefer it when there's no choice, because so that if you want to change the pose or what have you of the figure, you've got to convert it yourself. I actually prefer that. I'm uncomfortable with so many small bits having such large hands. But there you are. X. Because he's going to be cool though. Looking forward to painting him. I do have the... book about Space Wolves. I've got a storybook about Space Wolves, so that should give me some inspiration for painting them. Of course, look on other people's videos, get inspiration to see how they've painted theirs, and then do my own version how I want. Of course, Nick from Midic Beer's 13th Company Wolves are very inspiring. Kind of urging me onwards to get these done. I was going to mix it up a bit, I think. I mean, I know a lot of people are going the 30k route, but I won't be, because it's just too damn expensive, to be truthful. yeah, you get your base models and the Betrayal at Kalf starter set, but the rest of it's Forge World, and I just can't afford that. Sorry, but I can't. Everybody's got their limits, and this is mine. 40k is as expensive as I can go. And that's expensive enough. Right, that's good. So yeah, on the wargaming side, I am concentrating more on the GW stuff. The made up stuff, because, well, I'm really, really enjoying it at the moment. That plus I'm reading the Horus Heresy novels anyway. Not, like I just said, I'm not into Horus Heresy, but the fluff in general, where it all began and all that kind of stuff, I love reading about the background. There's probably more background stuff on this than the actual historical. Right. I imagine Lord of the Rings has got a nice bit of fluff going on with it as well, because it's got a lot. Tolkien wrote an awful lot about Lord of the Rings, didn't he? Fleshed out the histories and wrote the Elvish language and goodness knows what else. So, yeah. Lord of the Rings, I suppose I'm quite drawn to that as a game. But the scales, I don't think it's heroic scale like Warhammer is, so I'm more of a heroic scale fan, I've got to be honest. Although I would go 15mm into something like American Civil War or something of that ilk, purely so I could see numbers on the table, really, and slightly more epicness to it. Warhammer epic, would I look at that? I couldn't really, I just couldn't afford it. If I could afford it, would I? Possibly, if I was really rich. But as it stands, no. And if I had more money, I'd spend it on other things, and other games, and other units, that kind of thing. So this is it's actually quite. I find this very therapeutic. Just sat here, chilling, chewing the fat with you guys. You've seen some of my battle boards by now, mats. So you kind of get an idea of what's going to come up in the future. Not sure when I'll be uploading this video yet. Just filming it ready. I like to have at least one video on the back burner. Ready. Because I'm going to start scheduling more of my videos as well. Because it can be very, very handy doing that. Especially if you've got a weekly series that goes out and you happen to have filmed it already, and that you can do that. That's pretty awesome, because the It saves you having to worry about it, you know. So I'm going, ha-ha, because I've seen where and how the piece fits. But let's hold that there for a second. Put his axe on as well sometime. Chrom Dragon Gaze. I think he's turning out all right. So far, so good. Yeah. Right, just make sure that this is done. I've still got to bring over some of my armies from my house to this studio here because I haven't got them all yet. So far, it's just my Ultramarines and my Blood Angels, the only two complete armies. Oh, and my Orcs, the only three complete armies I have over here. My Tyranids, just only got a few. Right, okay. Got my dog sat next to me on the chair next to me. He likes to come out here and keep me company, so. And I like his company too. He likes watching videos more than being on. He did something funny today. I was watching an episode of Ice Road Truckers, actually the last one in the series one. And there were some foxes and deer on the screen, you know, to talk about the wildlife that they see. And they're driving their trucks. And there was a fox on the screen. Because my dog, Rufus, he loves the TV. He absolutely loves it. And so he was sat there watching this fox. Then the fox ran off screen. And he ran behind the TV looking for it. It was hilarious. It was, really was. It was so funny. So what have we got to put on next? Shoulder pads. You know, shoulder pads, Space Marine shoulder pads are my nemesis when it comes to putting transfers or decals on. I think they're the hardest surface because of the curvature of the surface. They're the hardest surface to put a decal on, and unfortunately that was where I started trying to put transfers on, and of course thinking, makes you think you're really crap at doing it because you can't do it. I mean, it's put it on a flat surface, piece of cake, you know, easy. But shoulder pads, no, you got to use all manner of decal shrinking things and mediums. I'm like, dude, not cool. We got some good shoulder pads on these though, they look good. My Fenrisian wolves can go with these as well. My patron has asked if I could do a tutorial on how I painted my Fenrisian wolves. And has offered to supply the wolves, so that might be coming up in the future. They'll be sponsored by my patron. I mean, that's fine. Yeah, if you're paying for it, have what you want. Okay. Right, so I think, yes, that one goes on his axe arm and that one goes there. Just look at his backpack now. You need trouble with all this detail. Is. It's hard to clean up some of the, a lot of finicky areas, you know. So I'm looking forward to doing lots of different series out here now. Now I'm in the studio. I'm going to be doing some. I'm going to get back on the Ronin bandwagon. And I shall be doing some Ronin videos as well. Going to set up a table. I might try and go through the rules with that. Just to show you how it works. So it's quite a good rule system, I think. I don't think any rule system is perfect, so don't get me wrong, you know, but I think it's quite nice. Yeah. Yeah, no such thing as the ultimate rule set, I don't think, but you can get some really good ones. It depends on what the rules are for, I think. So much stuff I want to get done, you know, and it's a little bit frustrating at times being a one-man band, knowing I can only do so much. So, yeah. So the YouTube channel of the week. Like I was saying, it's just literally, it's like a YouTube channel. I'm saying, look, hey, check it out, because I think it's cool. And you might think it's cool too. It's a bit like that Take a Look series where, you know, I look at things like websites and things like that. That people might otherwise miss, you know? So I think it's good for that. So if someone else mentions something, I always check it out. Because I don't like to think I'm missing something. It's always something new to be gained or learned or experienced. That is that sprue. When was it printed out? 2013. They're usually a couple of years behind by the time they bring out their actual sets, aren't they? So, its face is looking cool. Got some finicky though. Don't want to damage the hair braid. That's the thing. Little bit of flash where he was connected to the sprue. That's right by his hair braid. I do not want to. Ow, I've just pricked myself. Yep, made myself bleed. I do not want to damage the hair, that's the thing. So real careful here. Right. File. He's got a mould line on his hair there. Cool, this is finicky. This is harder than doing some painting. There, that's not bad. Not bad at all. Right, so what were we saying? Shoulder pads next. So this one will go on his, yep. Right, so I will use the thin glue. This Revel glue is pretty good, actually. It's good because I know Games Workshop do one with a little nozzle. Little tip, sometimes the nozzles on these things get clogged up. And even when you pull off the excess glue, even if it's dried up, it's still clogged up. And you think, oh no, that's no good now. But you want to get yourself one of those little wire brushes. bit like the flash brush you get with the Games Workshop. Where you do like it's like a wire brush, and it's better. It's quite good for metal miniatures. You can just poke the little ends down. It's the only things I've found that are thin enough. There, and it clears the way. Then, as you can see, I'm not a very fast builder. But if I get this done, that'll be the HQ for my Space Wolves done then. Once his shoulder pads on. He's telling me that that goes for his backpack. Right, okay. Fair enough, Gov. Yeah, that's looking all right. Now, I like to put little scores on the contact points. I don't know if you can hear that whining, that's one of my neighbour's dogs. Probably asking to come back in, because... Right, he's looking towards the direction of his bolt pistol. So let's just get the head on there first. That's looking pretty sweet. So there he is, Crom Dragon Gaze. There he is, all done. Right, so I'm going to place him to one side. Over there. Let's put the lid on this glue. Lift my glasses because I can't see what I'm reading. But actually, I'll leave him there so you can see he's in the picture. There he is. From Dragon Gaze. There he is. So what are we looking at next? Wolfguard Terminators. And it says there's 5 of them. Now that's going to be interesting to find the sprues for. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to start work on this Crash the Quiller. Why not? You may or may not have seen an update on this. This is something I've been after for some time. I think it's an excellent bit of scenery and terrain. Just gonna do this for a little while. Yeah. One piece. The larger pieces here. You can definitely see where it's been snipped off of the sprue. Come out a bit more, because you can't see what I'm doing else. Yeah. I consider myself very fortunate, very lucky to have gotten this. Actually, I was pretty lucky because came by courier, right? And I went out earlier this morning to get some electric for the key meter. And he came after I got back, so that's pretty cool. Normally I miss couriers. It's got a bad habit of missing couriers, huh? There's thing to go on. Crom Dragon Gaze there. So he's not done yet. I find out what flyer this is, and I might have done by the time this video goes up. I can get to work on painting him. I've got to be honest, I don't pay much attention to flyers, period, because I can't really afford to have them in my army, so I don't have the very competitive army or anything like that. There's not too much to do on these. Yeah. These files are really good for this. Right. Hope you're getting stuff done, by the way. I like to think that you're being productive. Or if not, hope you're enjoying just watching me do this, because it doesn't get much more exciting than this, I'm afraid. So, yeah, I might stop for a cup of tea soon, because I can. I'll get this little dude out of the way, because he's got more mold lines on than any other piece, so... Mold line remover tool. One of the best tools I have in my repertoire. I wonder actually if I could get a Battle for McCrag box set untouched. You know, I bet they're out there somewhere. Probably loads of dosh now, but I've got a I think I've got a rule book for it somewhere, Battle for McCrag, or the documentation you get with it. There's like a scenario that you can run. Sure, I've got that. I think it was my... Oh, I don't know if it was my daughter's or... I know she's got the old Tyranid codex. She thought it was so cool when she realised I was into Warhammer. She's like, yeah, you're into Warhammer? You never told me that. Like, well, yeah, I am actually. Nice for them to even notice you when they got their phones and tablets and things. I swear, sometimes they don't even know you're in the room. Kids, eh? It's You know, some places on Earth, they don't even teach handwriting anymore. That's terrible. Keyboard skills. Well, what happens when the computer goes down, defunct? I think everybody should learn to write. Some of those basic forms of communication, other than speaking, you know. I say, we're not going to teach you to talk anymore. You can use sign language, it's quicker. Right, okay. As you can see, a lot of flash on that. Glad to get that one out of the way. Yes. It's the R2-D2 thing now. That bit there, looks like R2-D2. Or an X-Wing or something. That's what it reminds me of, anyway. Time do we got? Nearly an hour, apart from stopping and starting. Okay. Well, mention now, but I'll mention it in other videos as well. Got a lot of flash there, wasn't there? Look at that, like, Mrs. Mini Warzone is walking across hot coals in bare feet for charity. That's how crazy she is. I said, you are crazy. So there'll be details of that up soon, if it hasn't gone up already. Still, I'm going to support her. I'm going to film it, actually. So you'll be able to see the event. Hot coals. Well, she's hardcore, my wife. I couldn't do it, personally. Right, let's get this guy back, and let's glue this bit on that I missed. Yeah, she's certainly hardcore. Now, according to this, it goes on just... There. God, that is finicky. If ever there was something finicky, that is it. May require the use of tweezers, which don't have on me right now. Let's see if I can do it like these. Quite improvising on the fly. Yeah, that'll do it. Yeah, that'll do. Crikey, governor. Now he's done. Oh, right. I'm going to call it a day there because I've finished him. I've done my Crash de Quilla set. I feel like a cup of tea. There he is. Chrom Dragon Gaze, I think. He's looking quite good. Let's just pop this on here.
There he is. Chrom Dragon Gaze. Actually, let's zoom out. Oh, you are zoomed up. Put the green background. There it is. So he's coming on. Anyway, I'm happy to have him done. Ooh. Got a strange tripod. That seems to stay level. I was trying to do Batman angles. Still not level. Anyway, thank you for joining me. So I've got my HQ done for my Space Wolves. Hope you got stuff done. It's an hour. Some of us can only fit in an hour here and there. So that's 1 hour. It took me an hour to do that. Can you believe that? An hour. Told you I wasn't quick. But anyway, other things may speed along faster. So take care of me, your glasses, and they'll take care of you. But I did clean up my crushed Aquila as well, so that's good. Thank you for joining me. I'll see you guys on the next one. It's a bit of an odd one, this. I have my dog sat next to me, although you can't see him. He's sat next to me. And he's, he's just snoozing in the chair. Keeping me company. Anyway, see you on the next video. Thanks for joining me. I don't know what I'm going to be doing next. Possibly more Space Wolves, but possibly I'm thinking Zombicide. I might be doing some Zombicide soon, because now I'm out in the studio. I did promise myself I would start season 2 of Zombicide, and we're going to start our zombie nights out here, and that's going to be good. So stay tuned for that. Keep your eyes peeled, and remember, all brushes lead to war, and in this case, all mold line removers. See you on the next video. Bye for now, guys.